Now, church revitalization is one of the EPC's strategic initiatives, and the GO Center is a ministry that has emerged out of the EPC to address this ever-present, ever-increasing need for revitalization among our churches. You know, our full report is included online. That's easy to find, so I'm just going to hit a few highlights for you today. Now, within that report, you'll find the following statement that relates to strategy and objectives. It says this: the EPC's statement of mission says, we exist to carry out the Great Commission of Jesus as Presbyterian, Reformed, Evangelical, and Missional congregations. Foundational to the strategy and objectives of the Church Revitalization GO Center is implementing this commission through EPC pastors and members. Missional ministry is inspired and informed by the Great Commission. The GO Center objective is this: to support missional pastors who develop missional leaders who lead missional congregations as we seek the lost and to disciple true worshipers. So we've got this three tiers: missional pastors, developing missional leaders who lead missional churches. To what end? To the end of seeing lost people come into faith, but to also see people of faith become true worshipers. Now, for a lot of years, I've been heavily involved in outreach and evangelism. So you might say that I'm sort of a Great Commission advocate. I just beat that drum all the time. And so there's a verse in Scripture that I have sort of hung my hat on for years and years, and you know this verse. It's Luke 19:10. It says, the Son of Man came to seek and save the lost. Well, I'm thinking if this is good enough for the Son of Man, should be good enough for us, right? Okay, seek and save the lost. So you know, for years, I've made that simple biblical case that God is about the business of seeking the lost. But in recent years, I've revisited that a little bit and expanded my horizons. And I was asking the question, well, okay, fine. If God is seeking the lost, what else might God be seeking? Well, that inquiry led me eventually to John chapter 4, the encounter of Jesus with the Samaritan woman. You know, there's about 1,000 things to be learned from that conversation, but I'll just reduce it to one, okay, for the afternoon. Jesus makes this statement. He says, an hour is coming and is now here when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Now, for a lot of years, I thought that verse sort of ended right there, but it really doesn't. It goes like this: true worshipers will worship in spirit and in truth, comma, the Father is seeking such people to worship him. So on one hand, God is seeking the lost, but God is also seeking true worshipers. Well, what I've come to realize is that we're talking about the same people here. It's not that God is seeking one group to save and another group to be worshipers. Why is God seeking the lost? He's seeking the lost so that they can become true worshipers. So what I've come to understand is that salvation is not the finish line, it's the starting line. True worship is the finish line. That's the ultimate objective. So truly, the ultimate objective of evangelism is not salvation, it's worship. Now, what we're trying to do in the GO Center is bring those two worlds together. You see, when Jesus says, go and make disciples, he's capturing both of these elements in one simple statement. Go and reach the lost and help them become true worshipers. Now, that's what's driving the thinking of the ministry of the GO Center. Now, our approach to ministry in the GO Center is not to revitalize churches as preparation for going and making disciples, but to revitalize churches by going and making disciples. Those are two very different things. I hope you see the difference there. And we help churches reach these objectives through training, through assessment, through coaching, and through consulting. So let me give you just a quick glance at some of the things that we provide. In the way of general training, there is what we call the G01 seminar. Many of you have been through that seminar. It's sort of an A to Z approach to revitalization. It's most often presented as one component of a full weekend called the Church Vitality Weekend. We also have something called the Leadership Ladder that's dedicated to developing missional leaders. And there's also an entry called X52, Great Commission Skills for Pastors. So if you see the link here, you see we have training for pastors as they become more missional. We have training for leaders as they become more missional. We have training for congregations as they become more missional. So when you put all these pieces together, we have a chance by the grace of God to truly move the needle. There's some specialized training that's available, first in the world of transitional ministry, which is becoming more and more an issue within the EPC as well as most every evangelical denomination. Bob Stauffer is writing point on that. We have ministry to help churches become more effective in reaching millennials. Bill Senyard is a writing point of that particular initiative. In recent months, we've launched something new that's called Go Business, the Great Commission at Work. This is the idea of recognizing the workplace as a domestic mission field. So one of the places we have as an opportunity to reach lost people is folks that our congregation works with. It's a ready-made pool of people that need Jesus. So this is a new initiative. We actually had a luncheon today to talk about that, that this was sort of the first unveiling within a national setting that we've done with this particular initiative. In terms of personnel development, we continue to develop Go Center Presbytery coordinators, some one person per presbytery that will be the primary link between that presbytery and the Go Center's ministry. We're developing Go Center coaches to come alongside churches and help them in the implementation process. We're developing transitional pastors to meet the ever-increasing need for that particular discipline. And we're developing coaches for transitional pastors. So lots of different things going on as our team expands and expands and expands. Now, there are two particular features of our full report that I want to mention today. First of all, there is what's called the Roadmap to Missional Vitality, and then there is the Go Power Project. So first, the Roadmap to Missional Vitality. This is somewhat ironic, but believe it or not, it's been 11 years since I started working closely with the EPC. And as we introduced the ministry that has become the Go Center, it was often presented as an approach to revitalization. Well, I hate to say this, maybe this describes you, but believe it or not, a lot of folks just sort of rolled their eyes. You know, like, not another revitalization program. You know, our church has been through three of those over the last 15 years. We don't need another program. We don't need another step process. We don't want to fill in a bunch of blanks. To which I would reply, well, this is not a program. This is a process. This is a way of thinking. This is a way of orienting local church ministry through the grid of the Great Commission. And that seemed to satisfy certain folks, and they'd open the door, and we would walk in. Well, guess what? 6 months later, the same people are coming to me saying, where's the program? Where are the steps? Where are the blanks to fill in? Okay, so we've discovered over the years that our approach of training and then simply stepping back with the expectation that local church leaders will simply take a self-guided implementation tour through our material, we've discovered that that approach is falling a little short. So we've gone back into our process and we have developed what we're calling the roadmap that really spells out how to implement the process. The process is now elongated. There are things that we do that are pre-training, then there's in-training, and then there is post-training. And the roadmap guides the way. This roadmap includes 5 markers that churches need to hit along this 18-month to 2-year implementation process. It includes checkpoints between the markers that need to be hit to make sure that we're being comprehensive and staying on track. It includes checklists to make sure that we don't skip anything, that we're covering the ground. And this can be done with 3 different levels of involvement with the Go Center. We have all of this spelled out in digital formats. So if a church chooses to simply receive training and then go with a self-guided approach to implementation, that can happen. That's called level 1. Level 2 would be to go undergo training, but then keep us involved more directly for about 12 months in a coaching relationship. But something brand new that I'm just now unveiling in the last month or so is a level 3 engagement called the Go Power Project. So I want to spell this project out for you. For one thing, I would like certain numbers of you to engage with this project, but I'd like all of you to be praying for this project. It's a rather bold, ambitious jump that we're taking here, because we really want to make a difference. We want to impact not just the EPC, but other evangelical groups that are also experience systemic plateau and decline throughout their churches. So I'll just take a few minutes to outline the bullet points of the Go Power Project, and then I will be done. I have taken it upon myself, just shy of 69 years old, to submit a 10-year plan. My goal is to be alive when we get to the end, okay? But short of that, we're breaking this project down into 3 campaigns. Campaign number 1 will involve 32 churches in a pilot project. This pilot project will run for a couple of years. The idea is to work very closely with churches to walk churches through this roadmap to vitality. In addition to the training, the assessment, the coaching, the consultation, we have 2 parallel projects going along with this. One, we've brought in someone who is a research specialist. And this person is going to be documenting everything along the way regarding all 32 of these churches so that we can clearly measure what's being done and be able to say very scientifically, this is what happens when a church does this right, okay? Parallel to that, we've got a training mechanism in place to develop many more trainers and many more coaches, because we're going to need those folks down the line. How so? Well, campaign number 2 will be the second 2 or 3 years. Our expectation is that the 32-page pilot, church pilot, will spring into being 100 churches in the second grouping. And then finally, the last 5 years, into 1,000 churches from multiple denominations. So as you can see, this is a rather bold objective. I covet your prayers, and I wish you well. Look forward to seeing you at the Go Center. Amen? Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Ken.